The Bandit was added into Halo Infinite in Season 3. This is the first weapon added into Infinite so far, and there will presumably be more to come. This is kind of a surprise though, as Infinite launched with a sandbox purist mindset. Every gun fills a role that the other guns don't. That is contrary to some of the other Halos where multiple guns serve the same purpose, like the beam rifle and the sniper rifle, or the light rifle and the DMR. I believe this was done because people did not like the new Promethean weapons, and they were saying guns should not overlap with their roles as a way to get rid of them. I think that the Promethean weapons had their own roles though, especially in Halo 5, where the guns were given even more special roles that didn't overlap with any of the other guns. 343 still went with the sandbox purist mindset and didn't even mention Prometheans, so their weapons weren't included either. But they also got rid of some of the fan favorites, like the beam rifle. In reality, having a beam rifle and a sniper rifle in the same game didn't really do much for the game, as they were both the same thing, just one was blue and the other was not. In the current game, some guns do seem like they overlap, but really they don't. One of the easiest to think this about is the sniper group. The S7 is just the normal sniper with no other special abilities. The Stalker Rifle is the least sniper weapon in this group, as it almost works as a super long range heavy hitting DMR. The Shock Rifle is similar to the S7, but has an AoE attack, and is also less forgiving with a 3 shot body kill instead of a 2 shot. Finally, there's the gun that I can never remember the name of, and always have to look it up, this thing. The Skewer is kind of like a sniper, but it has a 1 shot body, like the Binary Rifle, and bullet travel with drop. I feel that this is more akin to the Spartan laser, even more so than the Binary Rifle, as it's a one shot, and can do massive damage to vehicles, which is where I think it's supposed to replace the Spartan laser, but instead of charging up, it has a projectile time. The Halo Reach through Halo 5 DMRs are a medium to long range single fire UNSC weapon. The issue is that there were already two other guns that filled that role, the Light Rifle and the Covenant Carbine. These are not UNSC, but they are single fire and have the same range as a DMR. The Covenant Carbine is a little closer range, but I feel like that they serve the same general purpose. Out of these two, I do think they should have kept the Covenant Carbine more, as it felt more unique and had a little different of a role, but not by that much. They took both of these out in Halo Infinite, but we got the Commando, which I believe is meant to replace the Covenant Carbine with that fast fire rate and a little closer range, but it's still meant for longer range. And the Stalker Rifle replaced the longer range Light Rifle and DMR. But if I'm saying that the DMR has already been replaced, then how could they make it fit into the game without overlapping another gun's territory, specifically the Stalker Rifles? Well, they changed it. The new DMR is a close to medium range gun that has a low bloom, a tight reticle, and a 1.4x zoom that you do not get kicked out of when you get shot. The only other close to medium range guns that we really had were the BR and the Sidekick. The most different out of these two is the BR. It has a higher zoom that you get kicked out of when you get shot and is a 3-round burst. The BR is just a jack of all trades. It's good for close, medium, and long range. That 3-round burst also lets it perform better in certain situations that the DMR would not perform as well in. The Sidekick is a little more similar here, as they both have a 1.4x zoom and are single fire. The main difference is that the Sidekick does shoot faster and has more bloom, showing that it is intended for a closer range than the Bandit. Overall, this shows us some parameters for weapons that could come. We might see a slug shotgun in the game, or some other guns returning with a different function than the original, like the Light Rifle, which apparently had a file that would have explosive rounds, making it different than the DMR.